Howdy, folksy, and welcome back to Let's Play Drakensang, the River of Time! As per usual, we were just jumping on in here, and when we last left off, the elves wanted some help, so I guess we are going to help some elves. Where are we going? Apparently in this general direction, there are some ruins that there was wailing and gnashing of teeth and probably some form of undead horribleness. It actually looks like there may be... Okay, so it looks like we actually have to go back through the elf tree here. And it looks like there may be like a, I don't want to say a sky bridge, but some form of passage. Yeah, okay. Also, a friendly stench martin. Okay. So we do have this, and it looks like maybe a laboratory up there. So, let's see. There's Ardo, there's Healer Lady that gave us the quest. I don't know if, I can't remember if we've been up here. It's been a while since I last recorded this. I've not had time to record like I would want. Ah,
it must be you. Isaliel told us of your coming. Can I help you?
I'd like to barter? Okay. All right, so that's it. It's just like legit just bartering. What about you?
Are you with me?
The black feathers are sharp as bone blades. And he screeches. The howling of the dead, it hurts.
She seems to be lost in some kind of waking dream. Let's continue watching.
Singer, who is she? Is it Pardona? Nine horns on her head. It is the Skeleton Queen.
And we'll just leave her to that. So apparently, there is a Skeleton Queen. Maybe that is who you're looking for. Pardona. I don't know. Is that also a friendly stench badger? Yeah, a friendly badger, stench martin, whatever the hell those things are. No stone roofs over your head, nothing hard to eat, and worst of all, no beer. How will I bear it? I don't know. You're gonna have to manage. Leave off your muckery, scallywag. You tell them, Forgrim. They'll be taking any of Kano's shit. All right, what do we have over here? What is this? This is just a hostile stench martin. Trying to avoid one encounter, I've stumbled into another. Kano, do your... I'm just gonna have everybody do combat arts on these things, because I really can't imagine that they're gonna be too particularly dangerous. You know, they're badgers, and we're trained warriors. What is that, a pitcher? That's okay. Oh, if you notice, it's wet here. Wet is for drinking, not walking in. Ha! Some deer? I don't know if you've noticed, but it's wet here. Still wet is for drinking. Yes, we know. I do still really appreciate the area design in this game. The guards, unbelievable. They didn't even give them a proper burial. Now Ardo's in the hands of a bunch of loons and they don't even bury their dead. Okay. First one's told me the elves believe in the world of light from which they come and to which they will return. Maybe that's where their souls are now. You'll never know. A couple corpses. Alright, so this is probably whoever was sent first. I'm gonna quick save there real quick. Alright, we have beetles. Well, I know beetles can be dangerous, so we are going to buff. Summon your minion, and...
I am ready.
Let's see here, get some strength boosts on our party. Alright, let's get this over with. Can we pull these guys one at a time, maybe? I can't tell? No. Alright. I tried. It looks like we're getting like four of them here. I'm sure this is just gonna end terribly. Eh, maybe not. Forest beetle. Alright, these stag beetles, I think, are kind of dangerous. I seem to recall them ripping me apart last time. Seriously, dude! Three death magic! I know you got it in there. Whip it out and beat it about the neck and head with it. Ah, there we go. Ah, there we go. Chain that death magic, Devon. That's right. My good little death mage. Alright. I dare say we've probably got these things. We can loot the bodies. Assuming they have anything. Oh, no, there he goes. Oh no, he's harvesting. They don't have any loot. Alright. I mean, just skin them. Alright, I might as well, you know, get in here and look like I'm contributing. There we go. Yeah, that went really smoothly. I think Forgrim maybe was the only one that took any damage there, and he only took like a point or two. So that went much better than the last time we got, you know, chased around by beetles. All right, so what we're looking for is up there. But naturally, I'm gonna poke around a little bit to see if there's anything interesting. Another horde of beetles, which... maybe sneak around them. What do we get? We got a boar. Everybody get in there. Let's just have everybody do specials. Oh, apparently all we needed was Forgrim to do a special. I gotta know if there's something up here.
Hey.
Yeah, what? And gotta be careful about this. Because like, there's like five or six of these things over there. I don't necessarily want to anger the beetles that much. An urn, bunch of urns, and that looks like about it. That's disappointing. Anything good? Not really. Alas. No hidden, no. Yeah, I was hoping maybe there's a hidden chest. Oh, no, there is a chest back here, all right. I was gonna say, I was hoping there'd be like something hidden back here. Some diamond dust, tinder fungus, and nails. So nothing crazy, but you know, a little loot. I'm not gonna whinge. That's, you know, we came out of our way and we got some goodies for it. And I see that wicker basket over there too. But I fear the beetles, because these things I'm sure will just aggro in a small swarm, and yeah, I don't necessarily want to deal with that. Well, they are experienced. How much were those last ones we fought worth? Let's see here. Only four. So, I mean, it's not really a ton, considering, you know, we've all got hundreds of points on us. So, yeah, I'm gonna leave them be for now. Maybe I'll get them on my way out. We will see. Is there anything? No? Can't tell if there's any goodies hidden up here. Not looking like it. Alas. I tried. Well, how am I supposed to get back there then, I wonder? That's what, oh man, I bet you they're gonna force me to go past that beetle swarm, aren't they? Because it's all collapsed. You jerks. Man. I was hoping to avoid fighting beetles, but it would appear that there is no recourse. So, in that case, let's go ahead and have people buff. And by people, I mostly mean whatever you con. I can never remember his name. Right, get those stab buffs out there. Alright, I should have him cast it on himself and stuff too, but that implies I care about his well-being, and I really don't. Alright, so, no. Now you leave me alone? Oh my god! Devon! Apply death magic! I was gonna say, this thing shouldn't take too much to put down. The stag beetles that I'm really more worried about. Oh, we got this. We got this. Yeah! Run away! Run away! Get this one with. Get this one. No, you did. Oh my god. Just do whatever you're gonna do, Devon. Look busy. There you go. Masterfully done. Jesus, I just cannot get over how much damage Forgrim does when he uses that special attack. It is just incredibly nasty. Well, now that we've killed these things, I'm gonna go loot this wicker basket. Wonder what it hides. Perhaps thousands of gold pieces worth of small idols. Or more likely, a bunch of elf herbs. Damn it. I keep forgetting. Actually, while it's on my mind here, do I have... Alright, I do have alchemy. I want to level up alchemy on Devon. How high can we take this? I don't necessarily want to take it that high, because I only want to get it to the point where we can really... All right, so this requires a talent of 5. Moon powder is 2. And so I basically just need spring water, and I can make some one berry juice. However, it takes 10 one berries, which is kind of rough, but I'm sure, you know, if I'm a little bit more astute in my observations, I can probably, you know, pick up some bushes full of one berries. Oh, that would require me to actually, you know, pay attention to the landscape and just, instead of just roving across it, killing every hostile creature in my way, so... Probably unlikely, but you never know. Okay, so is this... Hardly wait, I wonder what we'll find in the ruins. I should go on quietly ahead and scout out the best way through. I don't think that's a good idea. If the ruins really are a sentinel of magical powers, my presence is most likely of significant relevance. Dude, screw you, Yukon. We got Devon. We don't need you for any of this. Alright. Oh, what do we have back here? It's just one. What is it? Oh, it's a bear. Bears are pretty tough, and it looks like we're gonna have to fight it.
Attack!
Am I worried? No, not really. Get that attack off of there. I don't know what you're trying for, Devon. And I guess, like, we'll just have Yukon do the same thing with the spamming of the death magic. There. See, and then you two. Let's see, 13.
Encore.
Do 2 of those, and 4 Grim. Mighty Blow is 20, you have enough for 2 of those. Alright, here we go. So this thing's gonna be getting the snot kicked out of it, and then a bunch of death mat. Yeah. Oh, 4 Grim, you botched it. I'm disappointed in you. Thankfully, you came through on the second one. Man, that deathmat, jeez. Alright, I'm pretty proud of that. The thing didn't even have a chance to really do anything. Just murdered it. Cause screw nature. We're a party of dwarf sympathizers. Okay, let's fast. Hey, cool, we got a fast travel here.
A new participant for my experiments. What took you so long?
What? I'm not here to find... I'm not here for an experiment. I'm here to find a remedy for my friend.
Two things that are not necessarily mutually exclusive, if you consider the horrors you must face in order to achieve your goal.
And what horror do you speak of?
A demon. Summoned by the ancient Bosporanians, bound by their power, animated by their knowledge, and controlled by their logic.
Oh, Yakan's piping in. A demon summoned and bound so long ago, I very much doubt that the magical bonds are still in place.
You clearly already have some superficial knowledge of the subject. In that case, you will soon learn that many years ago, great minds dared to carry out experiments beyond your imagination. Does that thought alarm you?
Ah, Yakan, again. Fear is the armor of the brave man. It guards him from the fate of the foolhardy.
Since you're already quoting me, you probably want to take part in my experiment. You will descend to the depths and face your fear. Look for the seal stones that manipulate the manifestation of the demon in the third sphere.
Why do you want the seal stones?
I am conducting a series of experiments. I am currently dealing with the competing relationship between fear and greed, taking into account mental deconstruction due to irrational influences. For each seal stone you bring me, I will reward you with an appropriate number of ducats or other items that may be of value to you. But remember, your life may depend on how you expend the seals. You can use the seals to reduce the demon's powers. But once you have used the seal, you cannot recover it. It is your decision.
I'll gladly take part. Now, I have a feeling that some unfriendly face said something. We're probably not going to be bringing him any seals. Because if there's a demon down here, I want to weaken it as much as possible. Because it's a demon. So yeah, we're probably going to just, you know, hold on to those and use them as best we can in here. I don't know. We'll see. Alright, so there's the exit. Nothing over here. I'm a quick save. Okay. Dark Amazon, are we supposed to believe the gate only opens by solving a stupid puzzle? Let's smash it. Do you think you want to risk destroying it? Never getting to Sanctum of the Dark Goddess? You don't my faith, Niven. It was I who begged Zafara Bloodblade to believe the words of the Hooded Man and follow him here. 10 long years, and I intend to gaze upon her beautiful countenance. Sisters, last night I dreamed of the Dark Goddess, but her face was terrible and white grimace of a skull. Okay. Alright, so we can talk to them. Which, I'm sure that's gonna just end in violence. Let's see what's over here. An ancient door. Alright.
Alright.
Okay. What in that? Oh, some skeletons. Alright. These are not aimless undead. They were created to fend off intruders, but who controls them? I don't know. All I care about is you buffing the melees, and then I guess yourself, and then summoning a fire elemental. I'm gonna look busy. Melees.
Time to leave.
Get up there. Oh shit. The undead. Holy jeez, these things are. All right, I'm looking busy. I'm distracting our enemies. Oh, this is, how's this going? I can't, all right, so one of them's down. This one's probably going to be having a bad day, but it's currently, all right, I can work with this. Okay, we're no longer being chased, so I can afford to stand around and throw some death magic. Ha, Yukon went down, and nothing of value was lost. Yeah, these things are pretty beefy. There we go. They're worth 5 adventure points. All right, get up, Stinky. Come on. Let me freaking heal ya. You are critically wounded. There, you're better. I'll even cast a healing spell on you. Because I care. 11. That is just an incredibly disappointing spell. Bleached Bones. Is that another? No, that is not a door. All right. Bleached bones, and bleached bones. I am mystified. Okay, so we have some miscellany laying around here that I'm going to smash the crap out of, because, you know, if we're in a tomb, we might as well desecrate. Some rare coins. Ideally, those are maybe worth a little bit of money. Old bronze coins. All right. Grab everybody. Oh, don't think I don't see you hiding over here, ancient door. Oh, I was trapped.
All right.
Thankfully, Forgrim opened it for us. Forgrim in dark, that. This place stinks of dark magic, but I'd crawl into every hole for Ardo. We must find that remedy. Forgrim, your loyalty knows no bounds. I can respect that. Over here. Oh, open door. I want, wow, if this is the map, this is a big dungeon. Alright, let's see, is it a trap? I'm sure it's a trap. I'm sure that door is gonna close behind us. Is it gonna happen? Alright, maybe not. That's surprising. Oh,
what do you want?
Kano. You wanna maybe deal with that? I hope you can, thank you. I'm glad there's something coming out behind him. I just saw it. Let's see, where is his, all right, his disarm trap is only at 10. I think I might wanna, nope. Oh my God. Skeleton mage, well, Where am I? No, Devon, oh my Lord. All right, get on this thing. Death magic, just all death magic all the time. Because this thing's going to be able to put out consistent damage on the party. Whereas these things, you know, have to roll to hit. This thing is gonna pull a Devon and is actually, you know, capable of dangerous things. I'm not too worried because our front row is pretty well armored. Well, Forgrim and Kano, I guess, are pretty well armored. So I'm not too worried about physical attackers on them. But magickers will just do horrible things. Alright. Skeleton Mage, what you got on you? Just some freaking bleached bones. This is just so disappointing. Give me, you know, some crazy powerful artifact weapon or something. Dang it. Okay, damn. It's like every game uses different buttons to like highlight things and stuff. I don't even remember if there's a button in this one to highlight interactables. I thought there was, but there may not be, and it's just, nah. Some it's alt, some it's tab. It's just all over the place. Bunch of charcoal. Don't know what that's, we do have a chest and it looks like it's trapped. Alright, Kano, we are going to spend these points to get your disarming up to max, and we are going to get your picking locks up to max as well. And, alright, your fencing is capped. You don't really need anything for special abilities. Let's see, 41, so I can afford to increase human nature and fast talk, I suppose. I will go that route. Not too interested in pickpocket. I mean, I use it. And, but it's one of those things that I could take it or leave it. All right, pick this lock. Please. Thank you. Right. And the goodies we got here. A part of a recipe. Cane lore might help in deciphering this. All right, let's see, the Bosparanian recipe has been updated. So I assume.
Yes.
Let's see, is this a quest item? Yes. Alright, so I assume that between one of our other characters, they managed to identify it. How to store it is of great sensitivity to wind and light. Alright. Should the robe become spotted, its protection will be altered. The arcane shimmer dust may not blow away and should be kept separately in its vial. It's one of many pieces of advice on storing this object. It consists of two components, a robe and an alchemical dust. It's an extremely complicated recipe. Obvious that at least one other part is missing. So this is fragment 2 of 5. They conveniently let me know just how many pieces I need. And that was worth 20 adventure points. Nice. Alright, so there's apparently some thing that we can craft. It, and naturally a plane is going overhead. But it's a robe of some sort. So that's, you know, immediately interesting to me because my party is kind of, I wouldn't say caster heavy, but it has casters in it. Oh, crypt lice. Huh. All right. Man, I wish I had some AoEs. Well, maybe not. These things don't appear to be too dangerous. Yeah, I think we've got this. Summon a new elemental. Yeah, no, we are. Like, even I'm managing. Well, Devon is managing to fight through. Oh, Kano, you just got nipped pretty good there. Got the gangrene and everything. Wow. All right, so we have one crypt lice here that is apparently the Antichrist. No, I don't want to actually do that. I want you to throw some death magic on this thing. Because it's killing party members. All right. Well, that was certainly a thing. Get up, Kano. Come on now. Me.
Don't do that.
Heal you. That. And have you do that. Get some healing magic flowing here. Is he still? No, he's still poisoned. All right.
Ready on call.
What does gangrene do? I have no idea. I'm sure it's unpleasant though. Okay, no, that's what you get for getting eaten by lice. Alright. I love it. We're like walking over the text. Burial chambers here. Okay, that. Like, I close this thing and sometimes it pops the menu up. That's kind of obnoxious. I don't know what causes that. I know I've bitched about it in the past, but still kind of annoying. Okay, so there's just a pitcher in here then. I'm gonna smash it. Might be something good. Nope, some sandstone. Okay. Is that. Yeah, I don't know. I don't see any goodies. I mean, there's some more pitchers and stuff, but those are just kind of like trash loot, I guess. No chests or anything hidden around. All right. Out of the burial chamber! I mean, at least we got some XP for killing some lice, I guess. Kano got gangrene. You go, Kano. Hopefully your legs won't rot off. That would be horrible. Let's see, so where... So this, there's a door down here, there were the Amazons down here, and I don't remember if this went further? I don't think it does, doesn't look like it. No. Alright, it's just not mapped on my primary map, it's mapped in my mini-map! I still do love the style of map in this game. Like, this is just, like, my favorite style. I've always liked, like, the hand-drawn style maps like this. Something that, like, the Grimrock games that always really, that I liked about their automapper is that it does it like you're drawing it on paper and stuff. It just looks really cool. Oh! Alright, Kano.
Yes.
Nice. I'm curious who's detecting those. It does not tell me. I think that... Okay. I think it's probably Forgrim detecting him with Dwarf Nose. Maybe not. Is that under Perception, maybe? Yeah, reduces chance of falling into a trap. Alright, so... So I should probably...
Yes.
Invest in Perception on somebody. Likely gonna be Forgrim, because he's in the front row. I don't necessarily want to go that hard into it, but... We'll give it a handful of points there. Does he have anything else I really care about in here? No. He's maxed on axe and stuff there. Yeah, I figure, you know, if there's gonna be traps and whatnot, I'm gonna give it to him because he's the one leading the party. If Kano were in the front row, then he would have it, but he's not, so he doesn't. Sucks for him. It's okay, it just gives him more points to invest into trap disarming and lockpicking and stuff. Gotta spread those skill points out. Cause I can tell you I'm gonna have Forgrim and Kano in my party for the rest of the game if they let me. I like these two. Yukon is replaceable as far as I'm concerned. Alright, so we have these Amazons down here, but we're not gonna deal with them this episode because we're already at like 28 minutes. I do, however, wanna really quickly flip through my skills and see if there's maybe anything worth working on here. Alright, so we're not investing in human nature on Devon here. Arcane lore. Like, part of me wonders if this is maybe something that you don't need on multiple characters, because it seems to just be for, like, identifying stuff, so I don't think I'm going to invest on it on Yakan anymore. So instead, we've got a fair number of points. I can get some, you know, some hit points, some astral energy. I think I'm actually going to grab some astral energy for Devon. Look at his spells here. Because, like, I've got all of the stuff that I use regularly maxed out. That's the thing. Yeah, bump up his treat wounds, I guess. Like, sure, why not? Plant lore. We will also max. There we go. Because I'm going to need to start gathering one berries and stuff.
Ready on call. At your signal.
Yukon, you are just... You just got so many leveling points and I just have nothing to spend them in for you. Let's see, he is still using a staff, so we will bump that up. I'm gonna have him focus on attack over parrying. I love how the text is cut off here. You guys need to resize your text box! And skill-wise, he's got like nothing... It's hilarious. I guess just willpower, and I'm gonna invest in. I'm gonna give him some hit points, actually. There, a little bit of health and a little bit of astral energy. There. I think that's probably about as good as we are gonna get. Forgrim, you've got 100 and some points. I could give you some extra hit points, but you really don't need them. Yeah, I think Forgrim's. I think Forgrim's pretty well set. So I think I'm going to call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. And I will see you next time when the adventure continues. And ideally, this interaction with the Amazons doesn't end in horrible violence. But I'm fairly certain it will. Until then.